Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Reading Time. Today we're going to read a story about kids in class, and particularly on the playground. So I want you to put yourself on the playground between Moreland and Brady, like you were still at Moreland and having recess. The only change you'll make is there's a big green space. So there's a tree and there's going to be some four-leaf clovers around it. So picture yourselves out there and picture the cool kids on the places they go to, and then the less cool kids and sort of the way the playground pecking order works. And that's what today's story is going to center around. Cool kids and the not cool kids and what it means to be in different groups. And I think you're really going to enjoy it. Before we read it, I'm going to put some more images in your mind. Remember, you're out on the playground. Cool kids in their spots, other kids in other spots, all the little cliques. And we're going to see some boys who are in search of four-leaf clovers. And I want you to remember that four-leaf clovers, look at that. I put colors instead of clovers. Come on, Mr. B. Four-leaf clovers represent luck. So they'll be looking for a four-leaf clover. And as you know, hopefully, they're generally three-leaf clovers, and if you find a four-leaf clover, it's lucky. You're going to see that the boys looking for four-leaf clovers can barely stand one another, and that means they don't really like each other. They're just sort of stuck together. And one of the boys is going to look across the black tar and asphalt. So he's going to be taking a view from the green space, like this little guy. And he's going to look across the asphalt, the black asphalt where the cool kids are. We're going to meet a character who all he has to do is wait for the world's adulation. And that just means everybody just loves this guy. He's popular. We all know the type. And they're going to use a metaphor to set up everyone. So you're going to have the cool kids who are going to be called the kings and the queens. And the boys looking for the clovers are going to be called stable boys. Those are the people who work at the lowest job for the king and queen. They're not even recognized. The nobility would walk past them without even saying hello to them. And then we're going to learn that someone has ambition, the desire to do more. He's going to be nervous about doing it, so he's going to have a little trepidation, but he finally decides to take a chance. And we're going to meet a boy telling a story about the Wienermobile. And this is what you should see. And this was very popular at the time period of this story. Fun side note, a friend of mine graduated college and got a job driving this car around the country. All right, then we're going to see a cuff of my jeans. And the cuff of my jeans is this stuff here. And his one side is going to be higher than the other, which is a fashion no-no. We have relaxed rules today, but you used to, if you looked different, you would be made fun of. So like today's society, we're better about that. But if you had your jeans messed up on the cuff, definitely reason to be made fun of. And we're going to see a guy in yellow shirt and yellow pants, and he is going to get burned by our protagonist is going to just light him up, because he's going to say, boys, I give you Tweety Bird. And Tweety Bird at the time period of this story, the setting of this story, would have been like SpongeBob SquarePants, just very, very popular. And I want you to have all these images in your head on the playground, just like you used to do between Moreland and Brady. And I want you to enjoy today's writing and reading exercise. And we'll answer the question at the end. Okay, email if you have questions, enjoy the story, and complete the writing for us. All right, we miss everyone. Take care.